Hello, you're welcome to Dr. Boms' YouTube channel. Trust you've been wonderful. Today we'll be discussing why some babies are born with a hole in the heart and what parents must know early in order to prevent this condition. We need to know that one tiny hole can change everything. Imagine bringing your baby home. Everything seems perfect until one day you notice your baby breathes faster than usual or struggles to feed. You think it's just a cold, but what if I told you it could be something deeper? Something most parents never notice until it's almost too late. Today, let's talk about a condition that silently affects thousands of babies around the world, and it's no other than a hole in the heart. We'll be discussing this in various sections. The first section we are about to go into is understanding the problem first. So, when doctors say a baby has a hole in the heart, what we're really talking about or describing is a condition known medically as a congenital heart defect. It means the heart didn't form completely and properly during pregnancy. There are different types, but the two most common are the ventricular septal defect, in which there is a hole between the two lower chambers of the heart. And then the second is the atrial septal defect, in which there is a hole between the upper chambers of the heart. These holes allow blood to flow in the wrong direction, forcing the heart to work harder than it should. Some are tiny and close on their own, while others are larger and require surgery. The scary heart. Many babies look perfectly fine at birth, with no symptoms as well as no signs. For example, no pains, no distress, and that's why it's often called a silent condition. Over to section two, how this condition goes unnoticed. In the first few weeks of life, most parents assume every cry, sneeze, or short breath is normal. But in patients with a hole in the heart, there are subtle signs that are easy to miss. You may notice your baby breathes, for instance, faster or deeper than usual, sweats a lot during feeding, he gets tired easily while breastfeeding, or bottle feeding, doesn't gain weight as expected, or sometimes has a bluish color around the lips or fingernails. If you ever notice this, it doesn't mean your baby has a heart problem, but it's worth getting checked immediately. A simple test like an echocardiogram can reveal what's happening inside the heart. Section 3, why this condition happens. So, why does a hole in the heart occur? We have just given a little preamble about the condition in the previous section. So, in most cases, it happens early during pregnancy when the baby's heart is still forming. There is no single cause, but research points to several risk factors, for instance, genetic conditions like Down syndrome, maternal infections during early pregnancy, uncontrolled diabetes in the mother, exposure to certain medications, as well as alcohol or smoking. Sometimes it just happens without any clear reason. And that is why antenatal care is so important. Regular scans and checkups can detect abnormalities early. sometimes even before the baby is born. So we move over to the fourth section. So this first section, we are discussing when to act in order to prevent things from getting worse. The earlier a hole in the heart is detected, the better the outcome. For small defects, doctors usually monitor the baby closely. Many of these holes close naturally within the first year or two of life. But when the hole is large or causing symptoms, treatment might involve medications to help the heart work more efficiently, and in some cases, surgery to close the defect. It's normal to feel scared when you hear the word surgery, but modern pediatric cardiology has come a long way. In experienced hands, these procedures have high success rates, and most children grow up to live completely normal, active lives. Section 5. Here we'll be discussing treatment and hope. I've seen parents walk into my clinic terrified, only to come back months later, smiling with healthy children that are happier. So that's the power of early diagnosis and proper medical care. If your baby has been diagnosed with a hole in the heart, here's what you should do. Keep every follow-up appointment, ask questions, understand what type of defect your baby has, monitor your child's feeding, breathing, and growth closely. Stick to prescribed medications and feeding routines. Avoid self-medications or traditional remedies that aren't medically approved. With the right guidance, most babies with a hole in the heart go on to live full, healthy lives. So we move over to the sixth section, which will be discussing prevention and antenatal care. So while not every case can be prevented, there is a lot expectant mothers can do to reduce the risk of a hole in heart in their children. Attend all antenatal visits. Please, we'll buttress on this again. Attend all antenatal visits. Control diabetes and maintain good nutrition in pregnancy. Fruits, vegetables, very important. Not in addition to your normal diet, your proteins, carbohydrates. You should take a lot of fruits, vegetables, and stay hydrated. Avoid alcohol, tobacco, unnecessary drugs. Protect yourself from infections during pregnancy. And most importantly, don't skip prenatal scans. They can save lives. Please, if you've just learned your baby has a hole in the heart, remember, it's not your fault. It's not the end. Medicine has made incredible progress in treating this condition. Early detection, follow-up, and care makes all the difference. If this video has been of help, please like, share, follow, as it could save another parent months of worry or even save a child's life. Please share this video. And keep subscribing if you found this video helpful. Keep staying informed so that you get more healthy topics. And this will be by you subscribing and encouraging others to also subscribe. I'm Dr. Boms, reminding you to be informed. Stay healthy, live inspired. Thank you and have a great day.